Assalamu alaikum. This time another lecture passed from the series about national stereotypes. This time about Arabs. This episode was about Arabs, and that's why I am dressed in the Jordan uniform, which is looking pretty modern. Okay, so one of the negative stereotypes already mentioned. Almost at the, because as usual we have put a table in three columns in which one was for negative stereotypes, one was for neutral ones or controversial, and the last was for those positive. Okay, so among the negative ones already mentioned at the beginning was of course terrorism. About terrorism is of course it's to some extent true. The problem with terrorism is if we would be in Europe 40 years ago, I think the answer about the Arabs and the terrorism would not be so obvious. In the 1980s, France and Spain, terrorism was even more, or the 70s, was even more up than today, and the radical Islamists like the guys from Algeria were responsible for only just a particle of it. So like just 40 years ago, Islam and terrorism not necessarily were so closely related in our minds, in our, I mean, European minds or Westerner brains. No, in the States definitely not. Arabs would be associated with petrol and so on, but not with not so much with terrorism. About terrorism, there are four main theories, more or less serious theories about how the religious Islamic terrorism, Islamic extremists started, and of course it implies the always the religious fanatism is first, and then is the terrorism. Usually it is so, because hardly nobody believes it's really political thing. And the left-wing parties, left-wing people usually believe and blame it to the problem, economic problem of the West via the Arab world, for instance, via the Islamic world in general, because as you of course know that there are 300 million Arabs. Jordan is only one of the Arab states. Almost no one, just a few states in which Arab lives, they are the majority, they're usually minority. Like in Iran, for instance, in Pakistan, they are, but they are minority. The same with Morocco, for instance. So there is a theory that the West is exploiting economically, or the West somehow provoked this terrorism Islamic thing with the colonialism, and the post-colonial movements are just a bit natural to happen after that. So this is the lefty approach. The more serious approach is that Islam, but still not a very serious approach, is that Islam somehow always must produce religious extremism and terrorism and things like that. Well, not necessarily. Of course, we know that they are based their social systems and legal system on just religion, which is forming no, there's no formula for a good growth of culture, because everything is just about the grade of purism in this case. They don't think with two ideologies in the same time, like the Chinese are doing with Confucianism and Taoism or Buddhism, for instance, or as we are doing with Roman, with ancient Roman legal thinking, more practical approach, and in the same time these Judeo-Christian things. So, and somehow this is all evening out in Europe, in the States, in China, and in the Arab world. They are basically doomed to just grades of purism. So this is so But it doesn't really speak to us why, it doesn't really explain to us why this terrorism is so active now. So there are two other theories. One is